trade is often singled out as a disruptive force in labor markets. And while trade does have that kind of effect, technology is actually the major force driving change and disruption in economies everywhere. Automation, digitization, and new managerial techniques, they're all revolutionizing the global economy. Productivity gains from new technologies are reducing the demand for labor in several sectors, particularly in agriculture and manufacturing. In some economies, including the US, 8 out of 10 jobs that are lost in manufacturing are due to higher productivity. They're not because of cheaper imports. But like technology, trade is also essential for progress. Now, it's not about rejecting technology. It's not about rejecting trade. It's about to embracing them and learning to adapt to them. Now, having made these points, let's not ignore that the overall benefits of trade or technology are of no consolation for someone who lost his job. So we must ensure that the global economic system is, in fact, more inclusive, and that it ensures that benefits reach more people, hopefully everyone. An important element in this equation, of course, is domestic policy. So this includes more active labor market policies, educational policies, the provision of support for workers. The fourth industrial revolution, as many call it, is not going to make all our jobs disappear, but it is going to bring huge changes, and we need to adapt. So there is no one-size-fits-all recipe, but success, I think, will hinge on the ability of economies to adjust to the changes. Turning against trade alone is not going to help it, is not going to solve it. In fact, it may make things worse. I think the multilateral trading system has a constructive role to play right here. We can do more to address these issues and ensure that the system can continue to evolve and improve. Of course, this is ultimately in the hands of members, and we know that some, including the US, have concerns about some areas of our work, and I am in close contact with the administration on this point. We've had further meetings today. We'll continue this dialogue. And I want to work with all members to strengthen and improve the trading system. Now, that is why I took the position of Director General. So this is an ongoing effort.